bitch. Bye, bitch. Bye, bitch.
What is up, guys? So today we are not doing the regularly scheduled program vlog, but instead I'm going to be telling you guys a story of my first fist fight ever. Alright, maybe that was a little too extra. Hold up. Body, bitch, make that body flip. You know I don't know karate, bitch. We dropping bodies, bitch. They say shooting is my hobby, bitch, and I'm a problem kid. Woke up on them with revolvers and they with that talking shit. So before I start the story, I want you guys to smash that like button, smash that subscribe button, and get the KO by hitting the notification bell.
No, don't do it. Man, shut up.
Yeah, don't worry about him. He talks too much. Make sure you hit that like, subscribe, and the notification bell right now. And now that you've done that, let's get right into it. So basically, this was summertime. And if I was to get into a fist fight, knowing me and how unconfrontational I am, it would be during the summertime because that's when everything is active. So on this particular summer day, I went to the park with my brother and a friend to play some basketball. And when we get there, we end up playing 3-on-3s with this scrappy ass white boy. So when I say scrappy, I'm talking 5'8". Buzz cut, looking like Eminem Scrappy, and the type of white boy to foul you hard as fuck with no remorse. The type of fouls that will give you a scratch like this. Like,
no.
So as we're playing threes, me and this white boy are talking shit to each other, and we start going mad aggressive. So every time we drive to the rim, we start putting our shoulders down. And this dude just keeps following me harder and harder, and he's like jumping on me. But eventually the 3-on-3s die down and it starts getting dark out, so we start playing 50. So I'm like, yo, where are you from, bro? And he's like, yo, I'm from Mattapan. And if you're not from the Boston area, Mattapan would be considered inner city or the HOOD, you feel me? And that shit was bad corny. So my city is right above Boston, and where he's from is right below Boston. So it would be like a 45 minute drive or like a 1 hour train ride to get there. And mind you, this dude pulled up on his bike. So I was just mad confused on why he was there in the first place. And I was right to feel that way because during the middle of the 50 game, he mysteriously left and no one really noticed he left until he was way outside the park on his bike. And everyone's like, all right, peace out, bro. Like, I'll see you next time. And then this dude did not look back one time, and he was biking mad fast around the whole block. And after he left, we're all like, yo, this dude is mad weird. Like, why'd he just leave mad fast like that? So then my brother ran to the other side of the court and he's like, yo, this dude took my phone. So my brother left his phone lacking on the whole other side of the court, which is his own fault, but he didn't think someone was gonna steal it. But today, we had to run into Scrappy White Boy from Mattapan. And the consensus that me and my boy reached at the end of the night was, if we ever catch this dude, we're about to fuck him up. And that's exactly what happened 2 months later. So fast forward 2 months, it's still summertime and I'm chilling with my girl and the same boy that I was playing basketball with the night my brother's phone got stolen. And guess who we bumped into? Mr. Scrappy White Boy from Mattapan. So we had literally just walked by him and he did not notice, but right when I saw his face, me and my boy looked at each other like, yo, that's the dude. So we just played it cool and we let him keep walking, and the street we were on was kind of like a windy hill that twisted that way. So after he had walked like 3 or 4 houses up, we couldn't see him anymore. So we were at the bottom of the hill and we were plotting. And at this point, I pretty much had tunnel vision. I was like, yo, I said the next time I see him, I'm gonna fuck him up because he took my brother's phone. So that's what I'm gonna do. But also a part of me was like, damn, I never been in a fight before. Like, I'm actually mad nervous. My heart was like, ba-dum, ba-dum. And another reason why I was so nervous was because I was wearing Crocs with no socks at all. You see, this was supposed to be a casual summer day. You know, I was just trying to enjoy the sun, hang out with my friends, you know, have my feet out, let them things breathe. But instead, I was putting my Crocs in a sports mode, ready to fuck someone up. So then me and my boy start making our way around the hill. And mind you, the whole time, my Crocs are squeaking because my feet are mad sweaty because I was just mad nervous. But I told myself, I'm gonna do this, so I'm gonna do this. And that's what was on my mind at the time, no matter how nervous I was. And as we walk like 3 or 4 houses up the hill, we see that this dude actually just stopped and he was just chilling on a random person's front porch and he was about to spark up. So as me and my boy are walking up to him and he sees us, he's like, oh shit, what's up guys? And this dude's face was mad pale. He knew he just seen karma. And I'm like, yo, bro, let me get a hit of that. And he's like, nah, bro, I can't even. And as he's saying that, bro, my shit was so cocked back. I was like, boom. And I had sucker punched him mad hard, like slow motion. It was probably like, so then he gets up and then he starts squaring up and I'm squaring up too. And we're just swinging back and forth. And eventually my boy comes out of nowhere and just pushes the dude onto the ground. And then I'm on the ground, like hitting him like boom, boom, boom. And then it was like the scene of a movie almost, because a neighbor was like, hey guys, I'm gonna call the cops, stop that. Cause honestly, I was being mad loud. The whole time I was like, yo, why'd you take my brother's phone? Like, you don't do that shit. Boom, boom. Like, why'd you steal my brother's phone? Like, it was some emotions that went into that. All those punches, bro. I was hitting him with all of my heart. Like, my adrenaline was rushing, so I didn't really know how long I had been there. So I was like, oh shit, like, one thing I'm not trying to get in trouble with is the cops. So then I start backing up and I let him get up, and yo, this dude's stuff was everywhere. It was like a Sonic game. Like, I had knocked the coins out of him. He's trying to get his iPhone 5 was somewhere over there. His headphones were over there. He had a pack of papers, a lighter. His backpack was off. And then after I see his iPhone 5, I'm like, yo, but how do you steal phones? And you still have the worst phone. But afterwards, I'm not gonna lie, I was mad paranoid because I thought the lady had called the cops. I thought this dude was gonna come back with his boys, because where this fight happened was literally on my block. It was on my street. So as I was leaving, this dude was like looking down the whole time. I could see him from the end of the street trying to see where I was going. So I didn't even go home after that. I like went around the block to try to, you know, throw him off. I don't wanna have to worry about getting jumped by like four scrappy white dudes from Mattapan. Like, that shit was just something I wasn't trying to think about. And after I got home, I told my brother, I was like, yo, I seen the dude that took your phone, I fucked him up. And he was like, where? Dab me up. And a couple months later, I told my dad. And mind you, I'm Chinese, so I wouldn't really tell my dad any bad things I'm doing, but I had to tell him this. And he was like, huh, huh, which means good. And then he was like, dasuta, which literally translates to beat him to death. But you know, it's just a saying. It's just like, damn, like, yeah, you fucked him up. To this day, I never saw that dude again. I don't know where he's actually from, and I don't know why he was randomly on my neighborhood and why I randomly bumped into him. That was the biggest coincidence, but was it really a coincidence or was it meant to happen? I don't know. It's like no words really have to be said, because in my mind, that was meant to happen and it did happen. So that's that. That's the story of my very first fist fight, which didn't really count as a fist fight because I didn't really ever get punched. I was just doing all the punching. Make sure to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell, and I'll see you guys next video with more stories. Let me know in the comments if you guys like videos like this. Peace out. Yeah, look at the camera. Yeah, tell them what you did.
I was stealing phones.
Yeah, bitch.